right, guys. We made it to SHOT Show. It's going to be an eventful 3 days. Let's see what we come back with.
So a lot of people have been asking about wanting to shoot arrows out of our guns for a long time. People have been doing it by like sticking those air bolts down the barrel, that kind of stuff. So we went ahead and basically came up with a dedicated arrow shooter. So these use a system where the arrow slides over the barrel rather than in the barrel. That's been kind of around for a while. A lot of other manufacturers have done it, and it's been kind of proven to be the best way, we think, to shoot an arrow out of an air gun. Very. So much to the point that when we were testing them, we were stacking arrows on top of each other, splitting arrows, that kind of stuff. But kind of the big selling point of this arrow gun over other arrow guns is a couple of things. One, of course, like all of our products, it's American made. So it's made right here in the USA. Two, it's a 1500 PSI operating pressure. So if you were gonna like hand pump it, I mean, we're over 450 feet per second for the first few shots.
Okay.
And then it's not regulated, so it's gonna slow down as you go, but you're gonna get a lot of shots out of it. But the other thing is how light it is.
Oh, it weighs nothing.
Yeah, there's nothing to it. So it's all aluminum. Like I said, made in our Fort Worth facility. This has our new grip frame. We've actually adopted this grip frame across our big bore line too, so it takes AR-15 grips now.
Okay.
Which is kind of nice. People want to switch them out. So, yeah. And then we're doing two versions. So this is the Condor based version that uses an 18.5-inch arrow, which keeps it legal for deer hunting in a lot of states. You have to have there's arrow length restrictions and speed restrictions. So this ticks all the boxes to go hunt with it. We actually did a mule deer hunt out in Utah with it. I mean, 50 yards. Mike Owens from Mullet Man smacked a deer with it. It went 20 feet, piled up. I mean, we were using the Thorn broadheads, opened up perfect, went straight through both lungs.
Did what you needed.
Yeah, and then we're also doing the mini version. So this is based off of our escape frame. So it's a smaller version, uses a smaller arrow. This is more like people looking for an arrow gun just for backyard blinking kind of fun stuff. I mean, I think you could hunt like pigs. You can hunt in Texas, you can hunt pigs and stuff with them, but you know, not every state they're going to be legal for deer hunting, but still a cool little gun. And we're still kind of in development on these, but we're nearing the final production kind of point, getting there. So we're looking at middle of the year, probably coming out.
Blackbeard for the MCX.
Okay.
I don't know if you're a fan of the SIG MCX platform, but
probably one of the first people that got the Blackbeard.
So these are the new things that are coming down the pipe.
We haven't put it in their hands yet, but we will.
AR-10.
Okay. So if you want the bigger one, we have it for the PCC.
Okay.
Pistol caliber carbine.
We don't have a release date for those
and
yet, but they
have,
are.
And then we have Blackbeard X. So Blackbeard X is down here.
Okay. Yeah.
That.
Right now, we are working on.
So this is Blackbeard, but you'll see it has a light here connected.
Okay.
This has the Mantis X functionality integrated into the magazine.
Okay.
So the Blackbeard you had, it's your point of impact data, resets the trigger for you. This has all the gyroscope movement tracking information and analytics that you get with the Mantis X system. So it combines
it
the two
still
systems.
Resets the trigger.
Still resets the trigger. But it has all the analytics connected to the app as well.
You come over here. What I want you to do is see the start-stop box down there. Shoot the start-stop. Give it, it'll do a three count.
Now,
you get each target.
So then you reset the target and actually I check target.
So now hit stop, or shoot stop, okay. So now it's gonna pop up on the screen, show you where your hit's impacted, and it's gonna tell you from 1 to whatever 17 where each shot is, so it'll say like, near number 1 shot was off the paper. Number 2, 3, 4, 5, and so it tells you where you've hit in the rings, so how many times you've hit the 9, how many times you hit the 1s, and how fast.
Like it.
So. It's pretty state-of-the-art and pretty awesome.
So, this is our new Hyperline, which we are super proud of. This was developed to be the thinnest 3A armor that exists, and I believe we have achieved that.
I think you accomplished it.
Yeah, actually, it really shines. This is a prototype hyper-concealable carrier that was developed specifically for Hyperline, Which basically adds no thickness and really does allow you to get all the benefit out of that. So this is something you can actually conceal under a t-shirt.
Can you clean the carrier?
Oh, of course, absolutely. I mean, it comes right off just like any other one. And we actually even are coming out with a new line of cleaning products as well. That are developed specifically for tactical gear, because as of right now,
nobody makes anything.
No, there's nothing out there, and it really does coat fabrics and cause issues and degradation. So this is meant specifically for all tactical gear, as well as an odor eliminator, which doubles as a panel cleaner. So that really protects the soft armor panels. That
so you can
there's
just
nothing
wipe
else
it on
out there
when you have the finished.
Exactly, you spray it down, wipe it off, and you're all good. A lot of people are spraying it with Windex or whatever else
which
they have, which
eats
can
through stuff.
Yeah, which isn't ideal for soft armor. So we came out with two products that are meant specifically for our industry.
All right, guys, we're here with Dave Galladay from LWRC. Showing us the California compliant for all my California compliant friends?
Absolutely. We're one of the only manufacturers that came up with a, what we believe is a really good California compliant solution, so you don't have to go featureless or whatever. But it's just the pin, the oversized pin here. Click that. Mag release works. Pop it back in, mag release is locked.
So you just tap it down,
that's
don't
all.
Need to do anything.
That's it. Where before you had to break the action completely,
yep.
And now it's just a, like I said, a
little push.
Little push, excess, back in action.
Can you run a full 30 round with that?
No, I think it's still
10. It's a good weight.
No, I mean, you can, but California, don't you have a 10 round?
We have a 10 round, but if you're grandfathered, you're fine.
But yeah, that and the one thing about this is that if you move out of California,
then you just change the pin.
$5
part.
Exactly.
Can't beat it.
And all of our models are available
with the pin now.
With the pin. For California, obviously.
Yeah. You just can't do an SBR.
All right, so cool thing that I know you'll like for, you know, all the tactical reasons, but also for me, like getting out the crop field and hunting, is a Sightmark Wraith mono, right? And you actually run two bridged. And it's digital night vision with 300-yard detection range.
Good.
Built the video as full color during the daytime, although I don't know that you want to run it during the daytime, right? It's like look out there and see. But digital night vision. So if you look at things like PBS 7, PBS 14, generational night vision with image intensifying tube, photo cathode, like that stuff can get damaged during the daytime, right?
Yep.
And it's also very expensive. Like that type
10K.
Of headgear can run $3,000 to $8,000. Where these are going to run probably $600 to $700 per device. And that's built-in video, digital night vision up to 300 yards. You have your display focus, your distance focus. It runs off CR123 battery. You can buy it pretty much any store. You're talking about probably about a four-hour runtime. So with a couple extra batteries in your pocket, you can go all night with these, right?
Gotcha.
It's going to be true one power. And so basically what we've got is you're going to have digital night vision helmet mounted capability out in the fields or any type of, say, tactical training for probably, if you run both, probably, you know, $1,200 to $1,300 range, I'm thinking, or you run one for $600 to $700 instead of $3,000 to $8,000, right?
Yeah, it's a lot better on the wallet.
Yeah, so I've been waiting for years for this to come out, and so I just found out about last week. I was pretty excited about that.
Sweet.
They're going to be compatible with a couple of different really popular mounts in the industry, different helmets in the industry, so I think it's going to be a big win for us. I know that some guys are going to use it for training scenarios and all that stuff, but for me, I'm going to be out in the crop fields, and I'm going to be hammering pigs with this stuff. We have this one. This is the same technology as what we just looked at the helmet. This is the Wraith 4K Mini. So we had the Wraith HD that's really popular with the base mag of 4X, and then we came out with 2X. People love that also. And then we came out with the 4K Max, a little bit larger, had an internal rechargeable battery. The display isn't 4K on either one of these, but they're high res. But they have 4K sensors, and the video output is 4K.
Okay.
This one has the 4K Max is a 3-power base magnification. This has a 2-power base magnification, and up to 16. All right. It comes with a throw lever. It is full color HD during the daytime, and then digital night vision at night with a 300-yard detection range. Also runs off of CR123 batteries. And the cool thing is that It has all the functionality of the 4K Max, but it's the size of an ACOG. Right? And you can, look how heavy that is.
Super heavy.
Yeah, right? I mean, it literally weighs nothing. So, pretty cool thing there. And Les, we're going to walk all the way to the other side of the booth, and I'm going to show you some really cool new Pulsar thermals.
This is going to be a modular night vision goggle. It's called the Adaptable Vision System. And this is the ATS, or the ITS, which is the Integrated Thermal Solution. You can add, you don't have to buy the thermal kit right away, okay? Thermal kit will include the eyepiece, the thermal camera, the OLED screen, and the beam combiner,
okay?
But that'll be its own kit, the ITS. So you could actually start with a night vision goggle only. And then build from here. So it has all the features. It has the IPD stops. It's got manual gain for night vision and thermal. This will also take a SWIR camera. It will also take a mission recorder camera of one that we would make. So if you didn't have thermal, let's say that was just a camera. If you didn't have thermal, it would actually record your footage the same way. And then the battery pack would house the SD card. So that's a cool option there. I think between eight hours. No, it's, you know, considering the weight's going to be, once it's all said and done, I wouldn't expect anything less than 2 pounds.
Yeah, so XT series, this is pretty much our brand new line of products. We're just debuting in a SHOT Show.
Okay.
So if you're familiar with LifePod, LifePod has a weather-resistant lockable storage. So we took that design and footprint and technology, we embedded it into a larger case. So we're seeing you basically have a modular interior. So all this stuff can be moved around. You have AD safe for ammo, pistol racks, magazine racks. As well as beyond that, too, the ability to lock this case. So you have two anti-impact latches up top, and the ability to lock the device up front. You have a backlit keypad, you tap the lock to enter code, as well as a fingerprint scanner. This fingerprint scanner is waterproof. So you can serve up to 20 users, so if this floats, if this goes in the water, it's all fine, the scanner will still work, as well as the ability this thing will float up to 32 pounds. So it's fully maxed out, it will float. And then beyond that, too, you have the ability to use a steel security cable to tether it around, you know, your nightstand, your vehicle, as well as the ability to fly with this.
What we started making was
pretty sweet.
Water. Yeah, we have different colorways too. You know, we have sandstone, we have olive drab, and our standard black model. All one size in XT, as well as we have other smaller models that you can take with you for single pistols, 2 pixels, as well as this larger model here.
The Kestrel line has a full line of products that we have available. So we start with the 2700. Okay. 2700 is your most basic. It's a single load and go. It gives you up to 800 yards, yeah. and that's it. So for like hunters, it's a great option.
Perfect.
Yeah. Then we move into the 5700 line, and the 5700, all 5700s have 3 guns loaded and a single target. So you can work with different gun profiles, but you're still just working on one target at a time. The great thing about the 5700 with applied ballistics is that it's field upgradable to the Elite. So you don't end up with like a wasted piston kit that you have to sell or do something else. You can always just upgrade it in the field. Then we have the Hornady Fordoff is also in the 5700 platform. So this has Hornady's Fordoff bullet library and the actual form factor and all the parts of the Hornady solver. So you can choose between 2 different solvers. The Elite is really the bread and butter. That's where most people land with the Kestrels.
That's where they start.
Yeah. It has up to 30 gun profiles, which can sound like a lot, but if you think about one rifle, if you run it suppressed and unsuppressed, that's 2 profiles.
Correct.
If you shoot a 130 grain and a 140 grain,
that's
another 2 profiles. And if you go from a Hornady 140 grain and a Berger 140 grain, that's 2 more. So it does add up pretty
quickly. It starts to get you there pretty quick.
Yeah. And especially for reloaders, those guys are really, as they're
super,
developing loads.
Yeah,
each one of those profiles is going to differ. So, but the app, you can have as many profiles as you want on the app. So you don't have to worry about having, not enough space with those 30 profiles. You can save them all right there.
Gotcha.
And then the 5700X is the top of the line.
I think that's what you're sending.
You probably
said that with some display.
Yep, and that's with the heads-up display.
Yeah.
So 5700X is a faster processor.
Okay.
It's actually a future-proof product that we made for the military. It has a processor that can handle a bigger, more robust solver that they may need in the future. So that's why we developed it. But then it works out for long-range shooters that it gives them their solution that much faster.
Exactly.
The heads-up display is Picatinny rail mounted. It goes right on your rifle.
And it's wireless?
It is wireless, okay. Yeah. It's Bluetooth to your Kestrel. You can do a wired remote if you want to navigate through screens and you don't want to leave your hold. Yep. But basically with that, you'd never have to leave your glass. So you don't have to lose acquisition of the target.
Yeah, you just open your other eye.
Yeah. It also works really well in a shooter-spotter situation. So the spotter can be updating all of the different targets while the shooter stays on glass. So
that's pretty cool.
Yeah, yeah. And you can do it nonverbal too. So if you're on a hunt and you're getting close and you don't want to have any conversations, the guide or the spotter will just be updating the holds, and that shooter, as soon as the animal presents, already has one.
They know what to do.
Alrighty, so we got Sarah here from Taser or Axion. Which one do we go with?
Yeah, Taser Self-Defense.
Taser Self-Defense, alrighty. And gonna show us some new stuff you got today.
Yeah, so this is our brand new device. We just launched it yesterday. It's our Taser Bolt 2. So this guy here uses CR123 batteries. We've integrated some technology to the device, so some Bluetooth. When you fire this device, it'll tell an app called Axon Protect on your phone that it's been fired. Dispatch will call and say, hey, are you okay? Do you need help? And if you don't answer or you say you need help, they're sending law enforcement out to the GPS location of your cell phone. So okay. One of those things where if you fire it and you kind of have that freeze response and, oh my gosh, what happens now? We've got that call for help already in place for you.
Gotcha. So what happens if you miss?
So if you miss, there's a backup stun gun capability. So when you arm this device here, right, the safety cap comes off. There's no batteries in this particular one, but say you deploy, I hit you with a probe, I miss with a second, I can use the front of this device to do a drive stun follow-up.
So you don't have to pull out.
Right, exactly. You don't have to pull the cartridge out. You can just do a drive stun follow-up, and that'll complete the circuit, so it'll give you a positive and a negative, that second point of contact, to be able to induce that neuromuscular incapacitation.
Gotcha. And yeah. Then still leave it and run.
Yes, yeah, leave it and run. We have the safe escape guarantee. So if you deploy in self-defense, drop it on the ground, get to safety, come back with law enforcement, and if the device is lost or stolen or taken as evidence, send us a police report, we'll replace it for free.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Can't beat it.
Yeah, we worry about you. You're not replaceable. Get to safety. Don't worry about the device. That's easy. We'll take care of that.
On the training standpoint, do you guys still offer the connection leads, or do you have to be probed?
You have to take the probes now. We used to do those, the alligator clips, yeah. But we don't do it anymore. Now it's you get the full meal deal with the exposure.
Dude, those hooks are vicious.
It's vicious. It's true. Yeah.
Like, we sent one into a 55-gallon plastic barrel, and I was like, it's not coming out.
It's true. The barbs are meant to be there for retention. So once they go into the skin, it's going to be tough to get them out.
It's meant to go through G.
Exactly. Yep.
And if someone's wearing a leather jacket.
Right. It can go through those thicker fabrics, the Carhartt jackets or leather, anything like that.
I got you. Yeah. Well, I appreciate it. Great to meet you.
Thank you so much.